Hey there, guys.
This is Mr. Logan here on Bighorn Elevators. And today is a really special day for me. Today marks my 7th anniversary of riding, filming, and taking pictures of elevators. It all started back on this day in 2012. I'm trying to find my remote. Oh, there's my remote. Yeah, so this is a little chit-chat about my 7 years of elevator photography and enthusiasm and all that stuff. And those of you who are just planning on becoming elevator photographers, here are some advice. So, I was like, I was 10 years old when I started filming elevators. Turn on my PS4. Yeah, I heard somebody texting me for a hate comment in my PS2 videos that get a PS4 or Xbox One. Well, I have both, actually. I don't know if you see the Xbox One, but there's a PS4. My Xbox One's next to the Wii. Get a Nintendo Switch. I sure have that one, too. It's actually connected to my projector. Ow. Oh. Good grief. I just stepped on a stapler. Actually, I just stepped on a staple. Ow. Guys, you should probably be careful with your staplers. Because that's why. Might as well go ahead and turn on the projector for you guys. See how big this screen is. Come on, camera, focus. Look at that! Logan's playing Minecraft! Of course I am. I got my... Come on, camera, focus. Hello? He'll focus in a second. There we go. That's my Nintendo Switch. I ain't got much games on here. I'm gonna try to get Animal Crossing for Nintendo Switch when it comes out. There's my projector. I'm gonna turn it off if I can. There we go. Anyway, so here's my experience after the past 7 years now. So, in 2012, I started out as just taking pictures of elevators. But then, a week or two later, I started filming elevators. And maybe at the end of the video, I may show, I actually still got the pictures of my very first picture of the elevator that I first took a picture of 7 years ago. Anyway, for those of you who are just now becoming an elevator filmer, elevator photographer, whatever, here's the things to understand. In some elevators, you must have permission to ride. At least the mall ones. And I fear for my 7th anniversary, I decided that I'd make a nice little compromise myself to go back to that Central Bay building and ride the elevator. So that's the good news. You might be able to see the Central Bank elevators again, but only the low rise. I figured myself, as long as I only ride the low rise. There is not going to be a problem. I'm trying to use a stand I made recently. Kind of see my TV. Anyway, looking dope. That's the iron brick road that I just built. And then in 2 days, I'm gonna go back to this red building. They're both at their final stage, and then they'll be completed. Except the red building, it's going to be a long way before that one gets completed. So, most elevators you have to have permission on. So, actually some elevators you don't need permission. And I ran to 2 new elevators I haven't been on in Lexington, and next time I go downtown, I'm going to film those 2, and maybe that one, maybe that Dover elevator at that 4th floor that had a really good motor that I was with my cousin on. I finally found a way to get into that elevator again, so next time I stop by downtown on the weekday, I'm gonna film it for you guys to see how it's doing and all that stuff. And I ran to 2 new elevators. One of them's unique because I don't think the door closes until you press the floor. Must have run into a vintage elevator with elevated fixtures. And that light up in red, which is really nice. I don't see a lot of fixtures that light up in red very often, so this is kind of a rare moment for me. So anyway, so if you plan on going to the Central Bank building, you know how in my previous video says I'm not going back to the Central Bank building. Well, since my anniversary, I went back there again. It says a song as I only stick with the low rise. You're gonna be good to go. And don't even ask permission and go on the high rise, because they're gonna straight up kick you out. Because I tried that and they straight up kicked me out. And they weren't friendly at all. So please don't try, people. Yeah, so I might film the Central Bank elevator again, but only the low rise though. The high rise you can't get on, even if you have permission. Even if you try to ask permission. Anyway, so back in 2012, all the way up to 2015, sometimes I was against elevators because I was afraid it was going to get stuck and we're going to get trapped and all that stuff. And then until 2015, I basically just ride every single elevator I run up to, except for service elevators. Unless they're on the same call panel, like the Chase building or the Big Blue building. And that's probably, no, not Chase, PNC, my bad. So I might find another way to get to Chase, maybe, because I think it had a bridge to the elevator, maybe. I don't remember, but there is I'll film those elevators for you guys. So, anyway. So let's travel back to 2012 and take a look at the pictures I have of the elevators I took pictures of in 2012. I actually have one from this month of 2012. You know what? I might just put all the pictures I have in 2012. Some memorable ones that bring back so many memories, especially the Lexington Center, because Lexington Center is going to get ripped out soon. It's going to get renovated soon, so that elevator going 2012 is not going to be here for any much longer. So if you guys want to film the elevator there, you better do it while you still can, while it's still here. Because if you not familiar with the Lexington Center well enough, they touched the Rupp Arena. They have not touched the Lexington Center at all, so why the Lexington Center is not touched, I recommend that any of you elevator filmers have filmed in Lexington, you should probably do it while you still can if you want any last moments of the elevator. Well, I'm not far away from Lexington, downtown. So I'm pretty close to downtown Lexington. So yeah. ...2014 was not the best year for me to ride elevators because people were mean to elevator enthusiasts most of the time. At least in my experience. Because I remember that apartment. I tried to go to Apartment Plaza. I only rode the elevator there once. I remember it was an Otis. One time. Then the next time the guy says, "You guys live here?" "No." "Out." We respect elevator enthusiasts. They won't ride. Well, I mean, I know that's your policy, but we want to ride the elevator. And school's elevator, you have to have a key. You have to be disabled, like on a wheelchair or servicemen in order to ride the elevator. Yeah, so that was a pain in the butt to ride the elevator there at my middle school. I'm down going to film my high school elevator. I don't think. Probably not. Anyway, 2015 was the best year for me to film elevators. Like, period. It was the best year. Because if you looked at my 2015 videos, I had a lot of elevator videos. I went to the elevators I rode back in 2015. That's some good stuff. Those were the good days. I miss it. I miss it so much. And then 2016 was alright. In 2017, I had a little downtime of filming. And so I kind of stopped filming elevators for, well, for YouTube in 2017, and 2018 I came back again. Well, I did film elevators in 2017, but I filmed them for my personal. But I decided I want to post it on YouTube for you guys, especially St. Louis. Yeah, apparently, I rode, while I was at the City Museum, I realized Diesel Ducey rode this elevator too. I bet Diesel Ducey had the same reaction as me. That tall ceiling. That elevator had a really tall ceiling. For a glass elevator. That does not go up that many floors. Yeah, I remember that. And St. Louis elevator. I'm probably lucky I even got to ride it before the elevator got stuck. Because apparently, weeks later, the elevator got stuck. And everybody on top of the Gateway Arch was stuck on the top. No elevators were working. Oh man. Imagine that at 8 o'clock at night. When it's your kid's bedtime or something. You're trying to get down. And there's no elevators at work. How much nightmare that you don't get. Oh man, I'm glad that didn't happen to me. I sure was lucky. And this year, I'm doing okay, but so maybe either Wednesday or next Wednesday is when I'm probably going to be back downtown. Maybe. So I'll see you in the next video. This is a nice little chit chat with you guys on my 7th anniversary of being an elevator enthusiast. Oh, and I forgot to tell you, how did I become an elevator enthusiast? Well, apparently, I looked at the elevator shaft at my granny's apartment because apparently the elevator was out of service and convinced me to take pictures and video that elevator. And I guess that's how I became an elevator enthusiast. What's my mama call me? Anyway, can't you believe that was 7 years that I've been an elevator enthusiast? Imagine being an elevator enthusiast for 26 years. That was Diesel Ducey. So when, what will happen to my channel in the next 20, like in 26 years? Like when it's my 26th anniversary. I wonder how many elevators I will run into in 26 years. I guess I'll find out, but thanks for watching. That is Bighorn Elevators. Grab the elevators, these records, games, by horn. Peace.